In political and economic debate, you often hear the claim that environment protection would somehow inevitably prove socially uncomfortable and economically painful. Yet, where environmental protection is secure, we see societies thrive and economies grow. Somehow, we haven't managed to quantify and fully take into account the benefits of environmental climate action. This week, the UN climate panel, IPCC-1, is gathered in Stockholm to present their fifth assessment report. They will again remind the world of the urgent need for action. But real action requires knowledge about its impact on our societies and guidance on how to prioritize limited resources. When I first invited Lord Nicholas Stern for lunch in the student canteen at Stockholm University in September last year, it was with an idea. It was an idea of a broad international scientific endeavor to identify win-win investments for policymakers and businesses. I'm extremely proud and excited to stand here just 1 year later and see the commitment and the passion from so many prominent people to will this initiative to life. And the cooperation between Sweden and Norway has, I think, and UK to start this up has been instrumental. I'm extremely grateful to President Calderon and Lord Stern, to the research team and to our fellow commissioning countries for all your hard work and for your close cooperation. The global changes we face pose an unprecedented threat to humanity. It's foreseeable and preventable, yet not enough is done. My ambition is that this initiative should provide new arguments and hard facts to push other drivers for action than purely moral. The world needs a positive vision to strive for, not just a gloomy future to avoid. Climate change is of fundamental economic concern for our societies. In Sweden, we have a vision to achieve zero net emissions of greenhouse gases by 2050. We offer an example, combining strong climate action with economic growth. Since 1990, we have slashed CO2 emissions in Sweden by 20%, yet GDP has risen by 60%. Economic instruments, a carbon tax at $150 per ton, and emission trading are key elements in our climate policy. This initiative will look at the perspectives of different types of countries without predetermined conclusions. It will include costs and address how economic policies and economic decision-making processes can be designed to harness the broader benefits of climate action. The final report should provide analysis and advice without being prescriptive in order to be relevant to finance ministers, business leaders and investors. We expect rigorous, highest quality research from the world-class team that has been put together under Jeremy Oppenheim. To further secure the quality of the analysis, the work will be scrutinized by some of the world's leading economists, and the prospects for success couldn't be better. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much, and let's go to work.